Hi everybody, welcome to our discussion on this topic, which is looking at the option strategies. Friends, we want to look at something called as a call option, and especially when I'm a writer of a call option, right? Which is basically the idea is that I'm allowing somebody that the other person can buy my stock at the price he wants to. Okay, between obviously agreed upon between me and him, and it's his option, not mine. So I don't have a choice but to agree with what you know, what he says to me. Okay, put simply, if I say that I'm looking at as a call option writer, I'm just trying to kind of bring some numbers around, think over it like this, and see to it what exactly is the meaning of that. Okay, say for example I'm looking at Walmart's share price. Okay, let's say the price today is $119, right? That's the current market price. I have 1 month call option where the strike price is $120, right? And the premium for that is $2 here. Okay, so the whole point is that if I'm writing this call option, essentially I'm telling that option holder that look, I'm willing to sell you this share at $120 a month from now. Okay, up to you whether you want to kind of buy it or not. So the choice lies with you, the option lies with you. Okay, and in lieu of that option, because it's a contingency, it's only a one-sided, you know, thing, so in lieu of that I'm seeking a premium of $2. All right, yeah. So when I say I'm a call option writer, essentially my objective could be confined to the premium. Okay, but then there is more story attached to it. We're going to come to that immediately after this thought process, right? The other party would have a thought that this share price would increase much more than $120, and he is willing to kind of give away $2 and expect a potential gain out of that. Okay, so what is there for this call option writer? Under what circumstances somebody should go for a call option writing? That is something that we want to talk about. Okay, and within that there are two things to be understood. One, whether this call option is a covered call option or is it an uncovered or naked call option. Okay, now finance makes the things easier for us by telling what is covered. Covered simply means that I already have the share with me that covers my position. Okay, but here I'm saying that this is without any ownership of that share. That is primarily the difference between a covered call option and a naked or an uncovered call option. Okay, so what is a good strategy, under what circumstances, which could be too risky a strategy, under what circumstances, that is something that we want to talk about in this scenario. Okay, say for example me as a writer, a call option writer, looking at the first scenario first, under a covered call option, think over it like this. Any price at expiry less than $120. It could be 110, it could be 100, it could be 80, it could be 119. Quite obvious to consider that the other party, the counterparty, will not exercise the option. I mean, put it like this: the market is selling the share at 119. Why would somebody be even willing to buy it for 120? He would rather let the option go. It becomes out of money for him, right? It means the option lapses, and for me, I receive this premium. Okay, right? Well, by the way, this is exactly the same thing in this case as well, right? So both the parties are certainly, whether you are under a covered call option or having a naked call option, the primary objective is premium here and premium here as well. Right? Okay. But then think over the other side of the story. What if the share price goes far beyond, far above $120, which means the option becomes in the money for the other party? Say, for example, the share price rather reaches $130 at maturity. All right. What would happen now? It would simply mean that while I could have sold the share at 130, I'm only able to sell it for 120, which means that there is a loss of $10 offset by a premium of $2. Net, I'm losing $8 by getting into this option, by writing this option there. Okay. Of course, if this increases further, then naturally the quantum of loss would be even more, right? But then, if you observe this scenario, covered call option, the whole perspective is that even if I say the share price has gone to $130, I actually have a backing of the share. That is, I any case have the share with me, which I would let go in the market. I would sell it for $130 any case. Okay? Which means that if there is a covered call option, there is a lesser risk of loss. Of course, the fact remains that you have to let go that security, you have to let go that share from your side. So you have to sell it to offset that loss because of an increase in the market price, right? So that is something which is about the covered call option. If it were a naked call option, of course, this is too riskier a strategy, certainly as compared to a covered call option, because there is no backing. There is nothing which covers your option, which means that for a premium of $2, virtually your losses can be unlimited. A great news about the business, a sudden, you know, let's say news of an acquisition, merger, acquisition, etc., about that company, let's say, you know, it simply raises that bar fairly faster. And that is where you start observing that a naked call option can be a riskier option. You are practically getting into an unlimited loss for a meager income of $2 there. Okay, right? So that is primarily the difference between the two sides. The question, of course, comes: under what circumstances should you go for a writing of a call option, when you are under a covered call option or an uncovered call option? We say that if you are, for example, not expecting too much change Alright? If you're not expecting too much of a movement, too much of a change, too much of a volatility, writing an option is a good idea. It does not matter whether it's a covered call option or an uncovered call option. I know that today the share price is 119. It takes a snail's pace, so every month the movement goes like 119.20, 119.60, 119.90, something like that. Okay? So practically what is happening is, I keep on holding the share under the covered call option. The share remains with me, and while the share remains with me, there is no movement in the share price, there is no considerable volatility in the share price. I keep on earning my premium for each such option. Okay, right? Of course, the similar thought process can apply here. Even though I do not have the share, but because the volatility is fairly at a lower pace, there is practically little volatility, so the premium comes to me here as well. All right, but the one big difference that you need to assess, that you need to observe, is that in case the share price falls considerably below, let's say it goes to $100 a share. Okay? Of course, both the parties still earn a premium because this is purely out of money for the counterparty. Okay? So, here it's a safe income, $2. You never owned a share practically, which means that even if the share price is going down, you don't seem to care. But in this scenario, if the share price has gone down to $100, you are earning $2, but your value of investment is going down. You should rather be letting that go instead of, you know, getting into an option just like that. So that is something which you need to kind of look at. Although when we say it's writing a call option under a covered call option, I would say it's a less riskier strategy, and it could be a safer bet, because at least some gain is insured, right? Even if the price is going down and you want to sell it, you still have a premium to take care of. Okay, it's a safe income that you have. Of course, the flip side goes like, if the share price goes considerably high, you have to let go your position from a covered position to an uncovered position. But nonetheless, this is a less riskier strategy under a covered call option scenario there, right? Look for it when you are owning some shares. You want to make some income out of that. Writing a call option is not a bad idea, especially when the markets are dull, especially the markets are not moving. When I say dull, they're just sitting it within a range particularly, right? So you want to make some income out of that. It could be a good strategy to look at. Of course, you need to be careful about it if at all your position is naked or uncovered in that case, because that could be sometimes a riskier proposition to look at, right? So that's it from my side in this case. Thank you very much. Good day. Take care. Bye-bye.